Styrkowicz, Styrkowicz. I shoot people. And there's kind of two ways that I do it. One is here in the studio, which is more of a longer kind of a session and goes a little deeper into someone's personality. And the thing I was doing today was a very quick corporate kind of thing where I went into a company setup, have a setup that'll replicate what I shoot here. So it looks like a studio shot, but it's set up in their offices. So try that too.
You want to put this one on instead of
that? Yeah, try that and see. But you can shoot. I did a thing back in February at the Nelson Atkins Museum where I set up right in the middle of their new block lobby. And the goal was 500 portraits in 5 days. And that was the week of our first snowstorm. So we had Wednesday and I shot on Wednesday, and then Thursday and Friday, the city was shut down. So we had Saturday and Sunday scheduled, and I had no idea whether people were gonna come or not. Well, in just 3 days, I ended up doing 813 portraits. I would say of the 813, about half of them I got on the first shot. This is a part where I have no idea what we're gonna do. But it's sort of fun, sort of scary, but sort of fun too, that I'll come up with something. You see the background, you see nothing of those flats or anything, it's just pure white all the way across. You wanna like,
oops, sorry. It's okay, just kind of put it on us.
But, Exactly. Put it behind you also.
Me too?
Yeah. And then say of people come into the studio for one reason or another, say 80% of them say that they hate having their picture taken or that they're not good at having their photo done. And that's what I've realized, is that my ability is really to make somebody feel comfortable and get them to stop thinking about being photographed and just react as a person. I kind of call it method posing. All right, so yeah, that's it. Yeah. That's it. Think of yourself, so you see. Oh, look at this. College, I was at the School of the Art Institute in Chicago. My senior year, I worked full-time in a photography studio as an assistant and got credit for my senior year of college for doing that. And then I did photography around Chicago for about 7 years. And it was all fashion, and it was for the magazines, it was for the newspaper, some of the department stores, things like that. You see that, like, hold it up high behind you. Yeah, just hold it in. You in? Okay, yeah, there you go. Yeah, up. There you go, yeah. Nice. And then I'd also produce fashion shows. So then people would say, well, can you do an invitation? Well, I do the photo, but then I sort of ended up learning graphic design just to put together the invitation. And then I ended up getting a job as an art director in New York. So I did that for a few years. And then through a friend of mine, I was introduced to a company called Limited, which back in the 80s was the hot teenage store. And I ended up being creative director over there.
That's it.
No, it's not looking.
You're like a magician. You're like holding it in front of her and you're like make her disappear. Yeah.
And she's there.
There you go. Wait, I think that looks. Oh, look at that.
Is that great?
And then I started doing that with my own business. And did that for most of my career, and then actually ended up moving to Kansas City about 9 years ago to take a job running a design group at Hallmark. And I did that for about a year and a half, and unfortunately, tragedy struck our family, and my wife one afternoon had a brain aneurysm and passed away. So I had kids who were 12 and 6 at the time, and so I stopped working at Hallmark just so I could be around and raise them, and because we didn't have any family here or anything like that. But once they were in school, it's like, okay, what do I do? So I thought about doing what I had been doing, which was consulting about innovation and creativity and stuff like that, but that would mean travel, so I couldn't do that with the kids. So I always had kind of kept my interest in photography, and so I said, okay, well, let me start photographing people again. Okay, now pretend like you're making that into a skirt.
Okay.
For her. Yeah, actually, like, put it around her.
Yeah,
yeah, there you go. And then get behind her. Katya, you come up forward a little bit. Yeah, so she can be back there. And then you, like, kind of find the opening to it and let your leg come out. Yeah. And you're, like, kind of showing it off. Yeah, yeah.
Well, aren't you guys? Sorry.
And pull it off. Oh. There you go. Then one of the breakthroughs was looking at a series of Richard Avedon photographs from the 70s, where he would photograph like the Joint Chiefs of Staff or the Chicago 7, and photograph them all kind of in a row against the white background. And I realized with computers, I could shoot people individually against a white background and then put them together in the computer. So I started doing family shots that way. And the beauty of that is, of course, you know, you have five people in a family, and I always say that you always catch the parents going like this, telling their kids to behave. This way, you photograph everybody separately, or you can photograph, you know, two kids together, or a mom and a son, or a dad and a son, or any kind of combinations. And so then we get like everybody being happy and silly and jumping around, and then I take the individual shots and put them all together. So you capture a scene that would be pretty much impossible to get in real life, and everybody looking good. So that became a big hit. And that kind of took me to another level with a lot of family pictures. And then from there, I just kind of come up with projects of my own. If you're just gonna kind of take it and go, kind of like that at first. But kind of, you know, do it with two hands so that like you're making it all stay big as it goes out. And then turn your head now right in the camera and just go, oh, hi there. Yeah. And then just try holding, yeah, just inhale a little bit. Yep.
Like, sushi.
Nice. Now just turn back to me a little bit. Shoulders up, in, face. And looking back after my wife passed away, I realized that doing it the way I did, which is that middle ground of doing something creative within the client's framework, didn't get me any farther than if I had just said, kind of like I do now, this is what I do, you want to do it this way, fine. You come to me, you trust me. And so that's my advice to anybody young starting out, is that you really have to look inside yourself and decide what you want to do. Yeah, more like that.
Salsa
dance. Try to do it, but hold it a little bit in both hands, but mostly move it with one hand. Yeah. When you want to get off the ground. Yeah, she could be like spinning around, or if not totally around, just kind of sideways like that. Yeah, because that made the fabric a nice thing. Yeah, really got to get it moving. Once we get the song moving, the harder advice is how you make a living at this. And that I don't even know if I can answer, because it's always been my beef with art schools that they should teach business and marketing too. And they don't. And the people who make it are the ones who have a natural instinct for marketing. And so that's the hard part, is that you have to do that as much as you do creative.
Yeah.
Back a little bit, like one step backwards, so you have a little more room, even a little more. Yeah, that'll be okay. All right, yeah. Nice.
Just change your leg position a little bit. Bend your knee. Yeah, shift your weight. You go out with one leg. Yeah. That's good. And then go out farther with the hand. No, stay there. Don't move too much. You don't have to move too much. You don't have to do a whole new pose each time. It's just parts of it that will change. So we really do it. Yeah. No, that's huge.
What I love about photography is two things. One is obviously the result. But to me, it's almost better. I don't know if I'd say better, but I guess so. The experience of the interaction between people. And the feeling, like I did say, I think that, you know, I put it at 80% of the people come in here saying they hate having their picture taken. And 100% of people will leave going, man, that was fun.
It's over for me. That's it. Nice. Yeah. And then pull that other one back that way. Yes. Yeah. And in fact, think of this a little bit like trying to think of your poses that you're just over with your body, just kind of make the little changes and stuff. Yeah. Nice. Yeah. Just getting the block. Stick yourself in one position. You know, just feel comfortable in it. Yeah. And now just play with the pedal. You're looking at these, and you're kind of like, this is kind of fun. Yeah. Ooh, that's nice.
I'm to the point where I can get something that pretty much I'm happy with almost every shoot. And part of that is knowing what I can do with it later. But part of it is just, again, that because I've been doing this long enough that I know when I've got it. And the other thing that helps with digital is sort of see and know that you've got it. Not always. But at least you have an idea that it's in the ballpark, and then it's working. I'm Tom Styrkowicz, known as 5'3 Tom. And I call the photographs I do amazing, the amazing photographs. And I've just been framed.